Okay, YouTubers, this is Steve Mack once again. I had to pop straight back in here because the situation changed somewhat with the lighting conditions and the fact that the eruption is looking far more spectacular. I didn't get time to go and post the last capture up to YouTube, so I think I'll hang back for a little while and do this in a few stages so we can get something more solid to show you guys. I know that this is going to update once again in a few seconds. Here we go. And when that's settled down, I'm going to go back to the Iceland situation for 30 seconds, see if there's any changes there. Just the ice moving towards us once again. Strange, the block that was over here on the left hand side seems to have moved somewhat, or sunk, or been covered by cloud, whereas the block on the right hand side has remained where it was. Maybe that was the impulse that pushing everything this way, I don't know. The way the tilt of the earth is at the moment and up in Iceland, that wouldn't surprise me if it was land of the midnight sun at the moment. That's quite a strong velocity current coming down here for these smaller particles. These blocks here are at least 10 to 20 meters long. Quite a movement. Let's get back to it. Yes, another spectacular change there. Dusk is rapidly falling now. This could get quite spectacular as the evening progresses. I will try and upload as many of these as I can this evening. Go again, connecting once more. Okay, I think what I'm going to do is shut a few things down. I don't think much more is going to happen here on the Iceland situation. The berg is broken up and it's moving towards us. There's no one falling in. There's no ships in danger. And I think we can record on this a little bit later on and just keep most of the bandwidth ready for the Etna cam. So all the best to you people in Iceland. More people still arriving. News must be getting about. People are congregating around here. Still people up on the higher level there and around this viewing platform here or the car park area. I might come back to this later on today or tomorrow, but wish them all the best there. Concentrate more now on Etna. Sadly, a lot of noise creeping into the camera now, which was a very good and bright and detailed image earlier on. Look at camera 2. connecting. Yes, and updating there just in the right time. Shame we don't have something live on here to see the intermediary 25 seconds or so. I think what I'll do is I'll go across to another camera. The thermal imaging camera. Let's set up. This page here is by a guy called John Seach. I'm sure that many people will know it who are aware of this form of trekking around and researching other people's work for dissemination in YouTube. Now I have the webcam coming in that Dutch was talking about earlier on that I've been viewing for quite some time. We'll pull that up in a moment. Let's just get rid of some of this. Let's just see if this refreshes first. Here we go. See here, dusk is falling, there is cloud cover, there's a little bit of luminosity here on the left hand side also here, and this peak as if it's hidden in between the peaks. And yes, it's coming up on the thermal image, but as you can see, these images are so far away, the camera's so far away from the actual peak that it's just nothing more than a little dot. But yes, there it is, it's evident, it's showing exactly the same profile as we're seeing on camera 6. Only there's a time delay somewhat here. I don't know if this is correct or if they've reset their clocks correctly or not, but it is currently 1952 on July the 30th, 2011 GMT, or 2052, almost 2100 hours. It's about an hour and a half or more behind. But at least it's there, or the clock is wrong. Let's go back to Etna on the camera 6. And yes, the profile is still changing here on camera 3, should I say. Let's go to camera 2 once again. Now we'll just be getting something like black and white here because the camera color is such a way off. The other cameras that are around the area. Camera 6 once again. Sorry, I can't get anything live here for you guys as far as real living images. It's just this time-lapse stuff, and there's nothing else that I can do about it at this stage. I will go and try and find another camera in between this next update and see if we can get something live. after this next update. We will call it a day here. Here we go. And that's it. Thank you very much, YouTubers. I'll look for something more with more vibrancy. Take care and God bless.